This factory simulation shows the process we'll use to explore how the Siemens PLC counter drives the counter display. We switch the factory simulator to run mode, and the counter starts counting pallets. The bottom photo eye on the safety light curtain detects each pallet passing by. The operator can manually reset the counter to zero. With this factory simulator, you can also toggle on the sensor tags. See color code status of sensor and the tag name associated with sensor address. Okay, let's pull back the curtain and see what controls this counter displays. In the Siemens simulation software, we have a counter function. You can see the current value of counter 107 matches the displayed count via the binary integer output from Siemens PLC counter. Shown here, the Siemens counter number 107 is programmed to reset if the operator's reset push button is pressed or the internal counter drone bit becomes true. You can see here, by pressing the manual reset button on operator's control panel, it makes the counter's reset rung become true and resets the counter to zero. The count then starts over. Now, let's take a closer look. We saved a copy of the Sort Height Basic program. We renamed it and added the word counter to it. So now we have a backup copy, a separate copy from the original. The Sort Height Basic is a demo that comes with the Siemens simulation software. We have the PLC in run mode right now, but have the editor in edit mode so that you can see the acronyms used for the different settings on the counter. This is counter number 107. It's counted up, incremented, with a photo eye pallet bit. In other words, a photo eye that detects each pallet released, and then it increments the counter up. Over here is a place where we could have put an output bit that indicates the counter is counting. But more useful would be a counter done bit. Like an Allen Bradley PLC, you would have an output for counter done. Siemens PLC doesn't have that. We'll create another rung below this one. That will have a comparative statement to create our own counter done bit. Siemens has the ability to put a preset in the counter. But you have to put a rung here with an extra bit. And it is a bit, pun intended, confusing. So we don't use this. We write our own compare statement below that, perform that functionality, put our preset and everything like that in the counter. Then you have a reset function. And we have the operator's push button that can reset the counter. Or it can automatically reset when we get our counter done bit, which is a bit we designed down here using our compare statement. We said, if the current counter value equals 11, then output to the counter done bit. And outputting to that done bit would make this true, which would reset it. So this counter resets itself after it reaches 11. Which in turn causes the counter display on control panel to have a 0 to 10 displayed. Then at 11, the counter gets reset to 0. So you don't see the value 11 on the counter display. You will notice there are two outputs here for the current counter value. There is a binary one, which is an integer, and there is a BCD, binary coded decimal. With a binary coded decimal, we would have to create yet another rung below network, or rung, 21. That would convert BCD to an integer. So, we just use the counter's integer output since that is what the counter display requires. Now, let's see it run live, and we'll see the values in here. The setting acronyms will be a little distorted here during the live run. This is block OB1. Block 1. This is like the main subroutine. In an Allen Bradley PLC, it would be called subroutine instead of block. So this is your main subroutine, OB1, block 1. We want to monitor that block, so we turn on monitoring. It gives you a little warning here that things are going to get slow and stuff. Capabilities get a little limited while monitoring. That's okay. So now we're monitoring the real-world values. We are currently in the run mode on this, so the counter is counting. 2, 3, etc. So, then you will see when this is true, it increments the counter by 1, from 4 to 5. And this is the current display value. It shows here when we are monitoring it. It shows it in hexadecimal. Even though it is an integer, it is showing it in hexadecimal value. So, when this counter's current value gets to 10, you will see an A here, which is a hexadecimal value for 10. There's your A. When the counter gets to 11, it resets to 0 automatically. That fired this bit when it got to 11 from the compare statement. 1. That's where the compare statement is. Right now, the current value in the counter is 3, and the preset is 11. So, when this current value reaches 11, this output would become true. That in turn would cause in rung 20, this to become true and reset the counter to 0. So, that's a closer look at the counter. Please subscribe, because in our next video, we're going to show you how to add the sort height basic program, this counter, and the comparative rung below it. We'll show you how to add them to an existing demo program that comes with the Siemens Simulator Bundle. Thank you.